I can do it as well.
You gotta pay her to hold.
Alright, so what does this say about Singapore's move towards becoming a green city?
Well, as you know, desalination and recycling of water now provide about 55% of our water needs. But reverse osmosis is an energy intensive process. Therefore, the key consideration now is energy, the security, reliability, and the price of energy. Because of this, PUB is now very focused on this issue of how do we ensure, from a both security and economic perspective, how do we ensure that we have enough energy to produce the water that we need. In the next 10 years, we've set ourselves the target of reducing our amount of imported energy for the production of water by half. That's a very ambitious target. There are two key ways we're trying to do this. One is with photovoltaic cells, solar power, what you see here today. And the other method is through recovery of energy from used water. That's basically biogas production. So the beauty about the current project is that there's been no capital costs to PUB upfront, and we literally saved money from day one because the recent fall in photovoltaic cells has meant that solar energy is now cheaper than grid energy. So we're looking at rolling out photovoltaic cells on as many buildings and PUB facilities as possible. We're also embarking on a trial of floating panels in our reservoirs. But because this is a brand new method, we want to be very careful about it to make sure it has no impact on water quality and on biodiversity. So over the next few years, you will see a progressive rollout of photovoltaic cells, both on land and on water by PUB. And you'll also see some innovative new projects for the production of biogas, and in fact we announced that last week in a new pilot project with energy. So watch this space, but as I said, the point which I'm most happy about is the fact that we saved money from day one.
Okay, and before embarking on this project, what were some of the bottlenecks that you faced?
Well, the key bottleneck for solar energy in Singapore is land. We don't have enough land. And therefore, solar energy can never replace our ultimate dependence on fossil fuels. But to the maximum extent possible, solar energy is green, solar energy is renewable, and right now solar energy is competitive with grid energy. So that means we should try to expand. Wherever possible, we should try to deploy that. And that's why you see, for instance, the recent Solar Nova tender, which was called led by HDB. The government as a whole is looking to deploy photovoltaic cells on as many rooftops of government-owned buildings as possible. For reservoirs constitute about 5% of our land area. Now, clearly, it's not possible to completely cover our reservoirs with solar cells. The appearance of water is still far more beautiful than that of a photovoltaic cell. So we can't do that across all reservoirs, but where we can and where it makes economic and operational sense, we will do so.
Is there an eventual target that you hope Singapore can achieve, like for example maybe 5 or 10% of the energy can come from solar panel?
Well, we hope that will be achievable. As part of our commitments towards reducing our carbon footprint, solar energy is one of the key ways we've been trying to achieve that. But I want to emphasize that producing energy from solar energy and also recovering energy through biogas are just two of, in fact, many other ways. A more equally important point to stress is water conservation and energy conservation. And that's why the less water we use, or the less energy we waste, or the more energy efficient our processes will be. So even from the point of view of PUB, we're also looking at more energy efficient methods in which to desalinate water or to recycle water. we're also looking at reducing the energy that we need to pump water to all parts of the island. That requires a review of our network infrastructure as well as our pumps and making sure we've got the most well, most energy efficient, most well maintained pumps, in the industry leading types of pumps. At the moment, it's buildings and reservoirs wherever possible. As I said, the key limiting factor for Singapore is always going to be land. So this cannot be a complete or only solution for our energy challenge. But nevertheless, the fact that we now have an opportunity because the prices are low and competitive, means it makes absolute sense. And this project, as I emphasized just now, has saved money for us from day one. And that means it's eminently sensible. Let's try to do as much of this as possible.
Is there a concern that the problem of haze might hinder the use of solar panels?
Well, haze will certainly make the panels less efficient. But that's something which we need to work on and resolve anyway with our neighbors, regardless of its impact on solar energy production. All right, shall we get a move on? We know the panels will be working efficiently now.